A very good evening, everyone. It is with pleasure that I, Aarti Jhingan, your host and dost for the evening, welcome you all back to the third and the final episode of the Ultimate Pitch Be Evolve Masterclass Series. By now, I'm sure you're aware that this year has been amazing yet again for the Ultimate Pitch 6.0. For over the past month since its launch, we've had more than 10,000 students registering and sharing thousands and thousands of ideas. And we are all having a fantastic new normal virtual platform experience. In the last episode, we revealed our semi-finalists. Now, in this past week, we and our semi-finalists have been very busy at work. The semi-finalist teams had the opportunity to attend an idea workshop conducted by our in-house experts at GeoGen Next Hub. The semi-finalists are polishing their ideas and gearing up to shine at the semi-finale and win the hearts of our jury to make it to the grand finale. Semi-finalists, all the very best. With us now being a more than 10K strong TUP family, it has now become a very energetic learning and a very, very fun TUP community. And this TUP community is growing every year. And over the past 2 weeks, this community has had access to leaders and experts from the Reliance world, sharing some remarkable global perspectives, extraordinary tales from the Reliance's treasure of entrepreneurial thinking, and their own inspiring stories of growth and evolution. Now, we are so elated, I mean, like really so elated from the response that we received for our first two episodes and are excited to bring yet another masterclass for you, our TUP community. One of the key aspects of evolving is to always keep gathering knowledge and keep learning. And that is what we shall focus on today, learning and its evolution in education. So to continue on this path of learning and evolving, it is with immense enthusiasm, or let me use the more millennial lingo, it is with super enthu that we step into the third episode of TUP We Evolve Masterclass Series with a wonderful gentleman who is a globally recognized marketing and innovation expert, whose insights have inspired a generation of business leaders to pursue success with significance. His career spans nearly three decades as an educator, a senior business school administrator, and a consultant to corporates and governments. He served as the Dean of the Kellogg School of Management and INSEAD Paris, as well as the Director of Sassen School of Management, Bangkok. With a bachelor's degree in statistics and honors from Guwahati University, he completed his PhD in marketing from the University of Texas. An award-winning scholar in his own right, among the many distinctions for his teaching and service, he's received the Parvasi Bhartiya Samman from the Prime Minister of India, an award that recognizes exceptional leadership contributions of overseas Indians. It is my honor and privilege to welcome Dr. Deepak Jain, Vice Chancellor of Geo Institute and a member on the board of Reliance Industries Limited. Thank you so much, Deepak sir, for joining us. I'm so excited to be sharing the screen that I think I might just forget my lines. Thank you so much for being with us. So, you know, with such an illustrious career journey, and I think I might need about 30 minutes to just go through the innumerable honors and awards that you have received, it is our privilege, the TUP community's privilege, to have you with us for this masterclass. Now, we have so many students from different institutes across the country who've joined us today for this live session. And the Ultimate Pitch platform, it inspires the youth to think big, it propels the entrepreneurial spirit in each one of us. This year, the theme for our event is Evolve. And we would love to know your thoughts and your stories on education, evolution, and entrepreneurial thinking. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Aarti, for the wonderful introduction. And I really want to thank you for including me in this great initiative, where we bring people who have gone through the journey with people who have started or already on the journey to become leaders who would create long-lasting impact on the global community. So when I was talking to Arun and I was asking him, what would you like me to speak about? He said that what the other speakers have spoken and what the theme is. And I thought that I will share with you. Can you bring the title of my presentation? No, the title. Do you have a title page or this? Yes. I thought that I will share with you what is called both the professional development of a person as well as the personal and the journey ahead, and share with you where I am today and how it all happened. Next, please. So just this part. So I go back. I was born and raised in a town called Tejpur, Assam. And I thought I will share with you a personal story. It was 1962, November, I think it was 19th of November, 1962. I had just joined the school and I was in what they call the KG class, my first year. And I remember it was around 11 o'clock in the morning. The headmistress came to the class and said that the Chinese army, or the China has attacked India, and the Chinese army is less than 50 kilometers from the school. Because when China attacked India in 62, they came from the northeastern part. It used to be called Nepha. Today it is called Arunachal Pradesh. They crossed Bomdila and others. And the first plain town is called Bhalupong, which is less than 50 kilometers from the Tejpur town. And the teacher said that the government of India has asked us to vacate the town by 7 p.m. We are trying to reach your parents to take you home. I remember my father came, we were walking back home. On the way, we crossed State Bank of India where they were burning the currencies. We crossed the district collector's office where they were burning papers. And I was more excited, not because of this, but we got a holiday. So now we don't have to attend the class. I remember we left in trucks that evening. And at that time, there was no bridge on River Brahmaputra. So we had to stay overnight on this side of the river. Next morning, through a ferry, we crossed, and it took us about 7 or 8 days to reach Rohtak, where we are originally from, near Delhi. So this is November 19th, 1962. 55 years later, on the same week, it is not the same day, but the same week, we ran as refugees. And I tell you, 2017 November, one of those refugees was announced as the president of the number one business school in China called China Europe International Business School, where I am currently the European president. So just imagine an Indian, currently an American citizen, being announced as the European president of a business school in China. What more can you expect? And I took this job for one reason, and that is the day we left as refugees, never thought that whether we would have good education. And then when the Chinese government is willing to put an Indian as the head of the institution, it speaks more about our country. And I attribute this success to the education system of India, and particularly to the devotion of Indian parents. When we were growing up, our parents had no concept of any vacation. Whatever savings they had, they would try to give the best education to their children, and which is the tradition till today. And that, I think, has made most of us. I have colleagues here, Mr. Rishikesh from IIM Bangalore and Mr. Goel from IIM Shillong and others. I think they also can share the same stories in terms of how our parents helped us get the best education, because that's the best gift somebody can give to others. So whatever I am today, I attribute it to my parents, and mostly to my teachers. The dedication that I saw on the teachers was unique. I never went anywhere from Tejpur. The first time I had to leave that town was because in Tejpur, we don't have a university. I appeared as a private student in my bachelor's degree from a college. And in 1976, some people came to see my father and said, Jain Sahab, excuse me for saying something in Hindi. Bola, Jain Sahab, aaj aapne paper dekha. Bola, kyun batao? My father was born with one eye and later on he lost the other eye. So he was for most of his life totally blind. Bola, bada, mujhe to kuch dikhta nahi hai. Tum hi padh ke bata do paper mein kya likha hai. To bola, aapka beta pure university mein first class first in statistics honors, mathematical statistics aaya hai. And you should try to send him to some IITs and IIMs for further studies. ना मेरे फादर के पास कोई रिसोर्सेस थे, ना कभी हमने इन सब का नाम सुना था, IITs वगैरह का. आई रिमेंबर द ओनली प्लेस आई कुड गो वाज टू गो टू गुवाहाटी यूनिवर्सिटी टू डू अ मास्टर्स इन स्टैटिस्टिक्स. एंड आई रिमेंबर समबडी टुक मी टू द बस स्टेशन एंड टोल्ड द बस ड्राइवर कि ये इसकी फर्स्ट बस जर्नी है, मेक श्योर दैट यू टेल हिम विच स्टेशन ही शुड गेट डाउन इन गुवाहाटी, नॉट द मेन स्टेशन बट देर इज अ स्टेशन बिफोर द यूनिवर्सिटी. That boy who sat in a bus in 1976 for the first time, I never knew that a day would come when I would become a board of director of the most global airline, United Airlines. So what I want to tell all of you is, everything is possible. Your personality would evolve over time. Your professional development would evolve over time. What you need to have is your passion and a purpose. Performance to me is a derivative. So today what I thought I will share with you a few minutes, how businesses have evolved over time and what we can learn from it. And this thinking that I will share with you happened to me sometime in 2012. I was the dean of INSEAD and I would say a big tragedy. I was diagnosed with brain tumor with cancer. And I had my surgery on April 19th, 2012. And the doctor who operated me was my executive MBA student in 1996. He had retired as a neurosurgeon in Chicago, went to San Francisco. But when he heard that I was sick, he was at the operating table. He didn't do the surgery since he had retired, but he was there to assist the new surgeon in case there were any complications. This is the power of teaching. Your teachers, your students, to me, the students have been my best assets. And not only I call them students, they are also what I call the co-creators of your professional development. So when I was recovering, I thought of thinking about global businesses. And as everyone says, when you have to think, think big. So I will share with you the last 500 years of businesses, what my personal readings and talking to people, what I have learned from them. Next column, please. So if you look up to the 19th century, I would say the business model used to be a model of colonialism. Today we talk about outsourcing. In those days, the country did not outsource. They just went and grabbed the country. We Indians were under the rule of British for 200 years or so. And I would say the players in those days were the countries. And the metric that was used to know how successful you are was what we called the power. I remember when we started our KG school, at least in Assam, there was a saying that the sun never sets on the British Empire, because Britain had the maximum number of colonies all over the world. And Assam is known for its tea, and most of the tea gardens in those days were owned by the British. So this is what I would say was the model, you can say, for many, several hundred years. France was one country, Dutch, the Holland, they had Indonesia. And if you see in this part, they in Africa, they acquired, and they were basically, we were colonies. next one. Then the needle shifted when America emerged. And not only America, but before that, the business model shifted from what I would call colonialism to capitalism, or what we call free market competition. And now the players were no longer countries, but corporations. You hear a company like John Deere and Company. I am currently a board of director, and we have been in existence for more than 180 years. It started in the 1800s. The oldest US company in the marketplace is a company called DuPont, which may have a history of 200 years or so. So if you look at the entire 1800 and the 1900, these two centuries, in these centuries, a lot of corporations came. You look at IBM, you look at all these credit card companies. Many of them have a history of 100 years plus. But when the model shifted to corporations, they defined their metrics as profits or market share. And that is what the definition became of success. In the first case, the power was an impact on strength, and this became profits of success. Next, please. 21st century, where we are today. Today, the needle is shifted towards entrepreneurialism. When I teach in business schools today, I see more students want to work for a few years, but what they would like to do is to start their own organization. And now the players are no longer corporations, the citizens. You see Mark Zuckerberg creating Facebook, Bill Gates started Microsoft, and lots of new entrepreneurs have created big organizations, starting from Bill Gates to Alibaba person, Jack Ma and others all over the world. You would see that the new players are citizens. But one thing is there, and these citizens, they have profits in mind, but there is also one more thing that I call purpose. When I look at my children, I have three children, they don't want to do something because of just it is a profitable venture. They have seen the profits part or success part. They also want to do something that would make a difference in the world. And that is what I called the journey of significance. So when I was the dean of Kellogg School, and every school has to go for branding, then what is, by branding I mean, what is unique about the Kellogg School of Management of Northwestern University? My brand of Kellogg School was, by joining the Kellogg School, you start your journey from success to significance. So from success to significance was the brand of Kellogg, because I always say, before you do anything of purpose, you need to be successful. Don't be an idealist. First demonstrate to the world that you are a successful person, and now time has come for you to give back to the community. If you look at Bill Gates, he created Microsoft, was a very tough person, built Microsoft, but one day, he decided, now for me, the time has come to give back. And day before yesterday, I was listening to him, and he said, when both Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos are talking about SpaceX and space travel, and they were asking him about his contribution to space travel, he says, I want to spend my money creating vaccines and creating immunization for the poor children. This is, to me, what I call significance, making a difference in the lives of the people who may not have the resources, but we all should think about giving back. And my first suggestion to all of you in the audience is, don't think of giving back that I will do this after I retire. While you are in the position, you should think of doing this, because the day you retire, from who's who, you become who's he. Chaprasi bhi aapko salaam nahi karega the day you leave the chair. So while you have the power there, think of how would you like to spend the rest of the life trying to build different things for different communities, societies, where you studied, whatever you did. Think of it. This is what I call a culture of giving back. So if you see this part, from colonialism to capitalism, today we are in the era of entrepreneurialism, and I will touch on it some more. Can we go to the next one? The second part is we are all in management education. And before I start the management education, I never went to a management school. I did my bachelor's degree in mathematics and statistics honors, and then did a master's degree in mathematical statistics, and came to US to do a PhD in applied mathematics and operations research. I have a habit of tutoring students. That's my hobby. So I used to help a lot of students who had trouble in mathematics or statistics courses. So one day one student told me one thing. He says, "Professor Jain, you are so good in math and stat, but you know, my suggestion to you would be that you should start thinking of getting a job in a management school and teach statistics there rather than joining a mathematics or a statistics department." I said that I have no knowledge of what management is and I've never been to a business school. So I went to talk to him, my professor, my guide, and he said that if you want to go into management, there are two fields that I would recommend. One is in marketing or one is in finance. And with your mathematical background, finance can be very attractive for you. I said that I have no interest in finance. I am not good in all these money management type of things. That's not of great importance to me. I said marketing seems to be more dealing with people. So I will try to get move to marketing. So he told me, he said that the best marketing school in the world today is the Kellogg School of Management, because they have a person called Philip Kotler, whose book everyone used to read. And this I'm talking a conversation I had in 1983. And I asked him, I said, why would the best school hire the worst person who has no knowledge of marketing? He said, "Deepak, have some aspirations in life. It never hurts to apply. If you don't apply, the answer is no. If you apply, maybe something can happen." My advisor wrote a letter of recommendation, and I think it's a courtesy to him that I got an interview at the Kellogg School. I made a presentation, and my thesis was on how you decompose a matrix into sub-matrices. So it was a mathematical decomposition of a large matrix. So I was writing on the board. In those days, we didn't have all this PowerPoint presentation. And about 10 or 12 minutes into my presentation, Professor Philip Kotler raised his hand and said, "Deepak, is this marketing or have I come to the wrong seminar?" I didn't know what to tell him. I said, "Professor Kotler, the only thing I can tell you, this is the future of marketing." And he gave me a job right there. And I tell you why I said, what is future of marketing? I said, treat the matrix as a market and sub-matrices as segments. The marketing means how you create segmentations, and the future is market segmentation of size one. We need to understand each individual, and I am showing you a mathematical procedure of how you can, if you have the aggregate data, how you can use that and go to individual person. Today we talk about data analytics. That was my presentation I made in 1985, and I did work for many companies in terms of how you think of creating market segments of size one. So let me share with you my understanding of management education as a personal consumer. Second column. So if you see here, the management education basically started, two business schools were started in 1908, the Harvard Business School and the Kellogg School. The oldest business school in US happens to be the Tuck Business School. They started the first MBA program. But the Wharton School had a master management program, but not necessarily an MBA. They started in the late 1800s sometime. But basically the journey, I would say today we are in 2021, the journey would be about 125 years. So up to 1960, the pedagogical tool in business schools at that time was case studies. The decision-making inputs where you discuss cases in the class and judgment and intuition. And the focus was on business relevance. In those days at Kellogg, the MBA program had a lot of practitioners. Classes were in the evenings, and professors came mostly from industry to teach. Next column. In in the 1960s, actually 1959, there was a commission set by the Ford Foundation where they thought that how we should teach management moving forward, because it was becoming very popular. And most of the deans of business school at that time were asked to come to Harvard Business School, and they spent a year there. And that is the time when management education took a more analytical approach, and people from basic disciplines started joining the management field. People like me with a background in maths and stats, people with economics, people with psychology, people with anthropology, they came, they built analytical frameworks, analytical models, and the focus became on academic excellence, because we wanted to earn the respect of hardcore academics that management education is not just fluff. Game theory, all the models of psychological theory, they started coming into the field, and this was the golden period where mathematical, where analytical rigor came, and we earned the respect of the global community of academics as well as practitioners. Next column. If you look today and we see 2000 and beyond, we are thinking of a new concept that has emerged in the last few years, is you teach case studies, you teach all the analytical models, but experiential global learning, how you tie business together with what you teach in the classroom, what I call a combination of rigor and relevance came, and the decision-making input, we also started thinking of business ethics. And this is in 2000, if you remember, in 2001, there were major problems, there was a financial meltdown, and also the 9/11, that thing happened. And actually it all started with the fall of Enron, and people thought that the managers or the decision makers were not ethical. And that is the time when also this whole concept of environment sustainability came, and corporate social responsibility. So I'm not saying that we are shifting. These are the things that got added, and the concept that this is my personal bringing is that business school started also thinking of social significance, that what we do for the society. And that's why, if you remember when I said that the brand of Kellogg was from success to significance, I sincerely meant it, that we need to do things. When I became the dean of INSEAD, they had hired a marketing company and made the brand of INSEAD called the Business School for the World. I suggested a minor modification. I said Business School for a better world. Not for the world, for a better world. I think it is our moral responsibility for we deans and heads of management education to think beyond business. Otherwise, I don't think we are fully doing our responsibility. Next. So I just use the term called, if you have to look at corporations, you have to look at business education and others. What is the, I use the term called the new diet. Can you put the diet here? I say there are four things today. First, no matter what you do, we need to have a digital platform or have a digital transformation. I advise my students to have an innovative mindset and entrepreneurial thinking, and the companies, the biggest thing they can do is to focus on developing the talent they hire. Time to time, we business schools do executive education, and executive education is nothing but, to me, another way of talent development. And I really believe that this is something we need to do, because in today's world, there is another concept called intrapreneurship, where companies would like to hire people who come up with great ideas, and companies give resources to them to ask the question, if you have to join this business, what would you do differently? So I say that this is what I describe as the new diet. Have a digital transformative concept with an innovative mindset, entrepreneurial thinking, and talent. The biggest thing we can do is human talent. And this is, to me, something very, very important. And I was also instrument. I remember the first day when Mr. Rajat Gupta called me, and I had just joined the dean's office in 1996 at Kellogg. And he said, Deepak, we think of starting a business school in India. And the first meeting was on January 20th, 1997, where I hosted this meeting. I was the deputy dean at that time. And my wife told me, Deepak, today you are going to have this meeting. It was at 7 p.m. And I said, yes, because that is the date of my daughter's birthday. So, aaj we are going to give birth to another daughter. And that was the day when the concept of ISB was born. And today you see it has been a great success story of a business school. I used to go there every 2 months when we were building the school. And not to be too personal, but when we had the inauguration ceremony, Mr. Rangarajan, who was the governor of Reserve Bank of India, was there as a chief guest. Mr. Chandrababu Naidu as the chief minister of Andhra Pradesh. Lot all the big business people who supported ISB. My dean of Kellogg at that time, Don Jacobs, who was a legendary dean. They all were there on the podium. I was sitting on the ground on the first row. After the ceremony was over, Dean Jacobs came down and said, Deepak, let all these people here meet the chief guest. For them, it is more important to meet these people. Let you and I step outside and create some space for the others. He and I are both big fan of drinking Assam tea. So, humne bola chalo ek cup chai peete. So while we were having a cup of tea, a reporter came and put the mic before Dean Jacobs and said, Dean Jacobs, I can easily see how great ISB is going to be for India. What's in it for Kellogg? Isse Kellogg ka kya fayda hai? I was standing next to him. He took me in his arms and he said, ISB is my way of saying thank you to this person for what he has done for Kellogg. So he said, ISB is my thank you to Deepak and the other Indians working there, because how he has transferred Kellogg as a young professor is what I would like him to do for ISB. So my point is, when you have good talent, age is not the relevant thing. I became the Dean of Kellogg when I was 43 years old. And by 51, I was out because I had completed my 2 terms. Just the next one, and then I would like to conclude. So if you look at the world today, I tell people that what you need is, among students, you need to think big, means you should be able to anticipate. We use a word called vision. I tell my students, we all live under the same sky, but we seem to have different horizons. Some people can see farther than others. We need to have the courage to deal with ambiguity. You don't get everything ready made. We need to build it. And sometimes people get depressed. And particularly, I would say this is a very big quality of we Indians. We know how to deal with ambiguity. And also we need to know how to deal with adaptability. How, because we can adapt to different cultures better than any other country in the world. Because India, as you know, is a country of countries. We have so many different languages, so many different people, so many different food habits. So I always say that knowledge comes from analysis. The wisdom, wise people, means synthesis, your ability to connect the dots. And that is one thing you get through experience, you get through many other people. And I, one advice that I would tell people is, for you to be a wise person, my definition of wisdom is, when people like to get credit for something, that credit, getting credit, is to me your ego. As a dean of Kellogg, I had an opportunity to go and meet the CEO of Coca-Cola. And when I went to his office, outside his office, there was a statement from a previous CEO of Coca-Cola. And I've always used that statement as a very important point in my life. And the statement says, there is no limit to what you can achieve and how high you can go up in life if you don't mind who gets the credit. So sometimes we get too much attached to this, ki kiska naam hoga, isme mera kya hai. Never ask the question, what's in it for me? I have always done everything in life. When Dean Jacobs asked me to do something, I never said that I am already teaching 5 courses. Because when people come to ask you, they are coming with some aspiration. And the last thing they would like to hear is no. I always told him yes. That's why when I became the Dean of Kellogg, one student came to give me a good gift, a book. And the title of the book was The Art of Saying No. He said, Deepak, now you have to learn all life. Whenever people ask you to do something, you say yes. And you need to know, mera ye hai ki if I can do within my time limits. I like to do that. And the last one. My only point to all of you is all this artificial intelligence, technology, that is not going to create differentiation. People can copy that. I have a saying that competencies can be outsourced. Trust cannot be outsourced. When Dean Jacobs told the person, this is my way to say thank you to Deepak, he had trust. You not be a chartered accountant, but you can always get good accountants to give you advice on accounting principles for the school. But trust is something you earn through your work. And I have always believed that in my personal case, that has made a very big difference to me personally. And my last point to all of you is, on this human side, some of you may have read the book, The Man Who Sold the Ferrari. You may have heard the book. And I tell you, in that book, there is a very interesting story. And the story goes like this, that the man one day had to write a business proposal for his company. He felt that working in the office, he gets so many distractions. So he asked his boss, can he work from home and prepare the business model? The boss said, of course, the due date is 2 days from now. I want you to get ready. He took a day off and he was working at home. And what happened was he had a young child at home and he had never seen Papa being at home. So he thought that's a great gift for him. So he kept coming and bugging him every minute. Okay, Papa. And now he had so much important work to do, the father. So he got really irritated. So what he did was, on the board in his room, he had a map of the world. He took that map from the wall. He tore it into pieces and he gave the son those pieces and say, I would like you to put these pieces together. He thought that he doesn't know the world and it would keep him busy for the rest of the day. After a very short period of time, the son comes back and says, Papa, I have done it. Papa goes to his room and sees what he has done, and it was a perfect map of the world. Now, outcome is the sight. The process to reach the outcome is the insight. So he asks the son, how did you do this? Did you know where these countries are? He says, Papa, behind the map of the world was the face of a human being. The moment I put the human being together, human face together, the reverse was the world. Ek aadmi kaisa dikhta hai, ye sabko maloom hai. So he said, the moment I was put the pieces together to form the picture of a human being, I was able to convert it into the world. So my only advice to all of you is, I grew up in a very small town with no formal education in English. I was telling Aarti one day that I studied English in sixth grade. Aur humko seventh grade mein ek translation aaya tha. कि एक राजा था उसकी अंग्रेजी करो. मैंने लिखा पेपर पे, एक राजा था, एक किंग वाज. मुझे तो अंग्रेजी आती नहीं थी. टीचर ने एक चाटा मारा, बोला तुमको ये भी नहीं आता है? बोला क्यों, क्या हो गया? बोला देयर वाज ए किंग. बोला ये देयर कहाँ से आया? बोला यही सीखना होगा कि अंग्रेजी क्या होती है. इन सेवेंथ ग्रेड आई डिडंट नो हाउ टू ट्रांसलेट इन हिंदी, एंड देन यू बिकम द डीन ऑफ अ वेरी टॉप बिजनेस स्कूल इन यूएस एंड ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड. This, I say, my teachers, my parents, my colleagues, believe in the people you work with. Wohi aapko upar leke jayenge. And never be selfish. Never ask the question that is there. My advice to a professor who gave me, when I asked him, I taught my first class in Guwahati University. A MCOM student, my age was 22 years old, and the students were 25. I asked Professor Sharma, do you have any piece of advice? He said, I don't know statistics. I'm a professor of organization behavior. I said, I don't need to know the subject. He told me a sentence. He said, Deepak, when your shadow becomes longer than your height, remember the sun is about to set. Dhalti sham ko, he says, shadow is your ego. If student asks you questions in the class, don't pretend and give an answer. You can tell them you don't know. You come and ask us. After two or three class, you can anticipate all questions. Never pretend to be someone else. Be yourself. The shadow is not lasting. You will last. So I just want to tell all of you, no challenge ahead of you is greater than the force behind you. Deepak Jain is always behind you. your colleagues are behind you, aspire for the best and work towards it. Everything is possible to achieve in this world. I have seen myself, and if a person with my limited knowledge and a very humble upbringing can achieve this, all of you have a much better and brighter future. My best to all of you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Your personal journey, it's so inspiring. And, you know, we have so many students as well as faculty from different B schools who've joined us today. And I'm sure there is just so much they would have gained through these last, 20, 25 minutes. I'm actually out of words to be able to even, tell you how inspiring this has been. In fact, my favorite part, I think, was, when you mentioned that Professor Kotler raised a hand to ask you a question and you could actually solve his query. So as a marketing student, I think that is just so amazing. So seriously, thank you so much, Deepak sir. So inspiring.
Just to say that answer I gave him, then he one day came to me and he said, I want to write a book with you. So we wrote a book called The Marketing Moves, How Marketing Has Moved Over Time. So I wrote a book with him.
That's amazing. And, obviously, sir, you have inspired so many questions and we are getting so many questions. So I'm probably going to take this opportunity to get right into those questions that we have for you. So I'm going to start with, naturally, your story itself is so inspiring, right? You entered the teaching sphere in 1979. Prior to that, you were yourself a student. So actually speaking, for almost half a century, you have spent your life in the education space and you have been witness to some various developments that would have taken place in this field. So if you could describe a little bit about your journey from being a schoolboy at Tejpur to the dean of multiple eminent global institutes, what are some of the changes that you've seen?
See, I always wanted to be a teacher. And this is a genes in the family. My grandfather was a school teacher. For 49 years, he taught 24 years as a teacher and 25 years as a headmaster. So he was the headmaster of Jain High School in Rohtak, where we were. So as I told you, my father had only one eye and unko acche se dikhta nahi tha. तो उन्होंने मेरा नाम रखा दीपा को कहते थे बेटा तेरे फादर को दिखता नहीं है यू नीड योर फादर कैन नॉट सी लाइट यू नीड टू गिव लाइट टू द वर्ल्ड यही मेरी बस एक इच्छा है तुमसे सो आई टुक दैट वेरी सिंसियरली और उन दिनों व्हेन आई वाज ग्रोइंग अप एवरीवन वाज सेइंग जैन साहब आपके लड़के को बैंक में लगाइए प्रोबेशनरी ऑफिसर या आईएएस ऑफिसर ये सब मेरे बड़ा बाबूजी हम लोग बोलते थे नहीं आई जस्ट वॉन्ट टू बी ए टीचर इन teach and I was lucky enough to get a job at Naugaon College in 1979 as a lecturer in mathematics and then very soon I got a job on February 15th 1980 at Guwahati University as a lecturer in statistics in the Department of Commerce and then they shifted me to the management department where I used to teach operations research and statistics to MBA students. Then I started, mujhe to marketing finance kya nahi aata, I just used to teach this. Now if I reflect back and see, I learned from the students a lot. And if you don't mind, I want to share a story with you. So when I came to Kellogg School in the marketing department, my head of the department said, Deepak, there are two courses I will give you. First is a basic marketing management course. That is what all young assistant professors start from. Maine bola ki I don't know anything about marketing. To main kya marketing management padhaunga? Mujhe to kuch nahi aata hai. So Gula, you have to teach something. Then he came up with this course called Market Research. And marketing research, mein, you have statistics that you apply to marketing problems. So statistics are mujhe aati thi. So he said, this is the only option. So I said, I will teach. So at Kellogg School, we teach twice a week, a professor. And our classes are 1 hour, 40 minutes, one lecture. And we teach Monday, Thursdays, or the other choices Tuesday, Friday, Wednesday, we give off to the students to do their case work. So Wednesday, no classes, students work on group projects. So I got Monday, Thursday, I taught my Monday class, I taught my Thursday class. And students didn't want to take my course but that was a compulsory course for marketing majors. And this is their second year. So they have to graduate this is winter term, spring, they have to graduate. So they had no choice. I came back to my office and I saw some students sitting there and they said, Professor Jain, We students from both sections have come here, some of us, to share with you our feedback on your class. So all students were sitting outside, three came inside, and I will tell you the name. The one person, his name was Fred Kindle, a Swiss guy, who later on became the chairman of the company called ABB Corporation, Ashton Brown Brewery. The second person, I cannot tell you the name because in his first class, he said something didn't make sense. I asked him to go to the right on the blackboard. And next day I was called by my chairman that my chairman received a letter from his doctor that Professor Jain put my patient into depression by exposing him before the class. I didn't know this was the US rule. So he used to work for Coca-Cola. And the third person's name was John Nielsen. And he and his wife in 1980s worked with Bill Gates and Melinda Gates. They were family friends. And he came from Microsoft. In my view, he would have become the next CEO of Microsoft or Bill Gates, but he died. He had leukemia. He died when he was in 30 after Kellogg graduation. I think he didn't live long. Anyway, so the person starts, and this is a story that I have said many times, but I want to say it because I want to listen to it. So the Fred Kindle starts the conversation and he says, Professor Jain, we all students met after your two classes and we have come to this conclusion that you don't know the subject. I said that this is my first time I'm teaching this course. I'm also a learner like you. But I said what people say is one thing, but you have to know what was the thought process that led to this outcome. Okay, the outcome is the sight, the process to reach the outcome is the insight. I said, how did you figure it out? I have given only two lectures. I have 18 more to go. The guy from Coca-Cola tells me, he says, Professor Jain, what you said in the class basically is you read the first two chapters of the book. And we had done the readings. All the examples you gave are there in the book. So we didn't learn anything new. And that is why we say that you don't have any mastery of the subject. Now, that is also true. I asked my chairman, what is a good book on market research? He recommended this book. I read. I don't take any notes. I write on the board. I don't prepare. I should not say this, but I don't prepare for any class. Anyway, this is my first time teaching and this was the book recommended. So I didn't want to make an excuse because remember, I was very honest. The third guy interrupts my conversation. He says, Professor Jain, by the way, we have not come here to complain. The John Nielsen guy. So I said, then what's the purpose? He said, Professor Jain, we all students believe that there is a great teacher inside you. And this evening is our promise that we will make you the best teacher in this subject. This is our promise to you. Now, how did they do that? Next morning, jab main aata tha mere office ke bahar, they used to keep cuttings from Wall Street Journal, Business Week. And they told me, Professor Jain, start weaving these stories in your lecture. Don't write on the board y equal to a plus bx and y is dependent variable, x is independent variable. Say y is sales and x is price or advertising. And start building these things. We will give you the stories and you can learn how to build these stories. My first quarter was tough. But from 1988 to 96, till I came in the dean's office, every year I was nominated as one of the top five professors of Kellogg. Students are your assets. I learned so much from them. If they see that there is something good inside you, they gave me so much materials. And every day they would come and say, Professor Jain, this is another story. Some people would come and explain my office hour. They will tell me stories. So my thing is, I have learned from my colleagues. Now that evening when students went away, a very senior professor of marketing was passing by and he said, Deepak, I have taught at Kellogg at 26 years and I've never had so many students come to see me. This is your first week. Oh, you saw so many students today. What did they say? I said that their major complaint was that basically I read the two chapters of the book. So they thought that I don't have any expertise. He said, let me give you the first rule of teaching. Prescribe a different book to student and you read another book. The concepts would be the same, the examples would be different, and students would think you're a master. Never read the book that you prescribe to the students. People give you all these advices. But one thing that my father used to tell me, many people get advice, few benefit from it. So my point answer to your question is, when people give you advice, they have गुड मीनिंग. स्टूडेंट्स व्हेन दे टेल यू क्रिटिकली इंटेंशंस को देखो. डोंट फीडबैक में हैव अ बिटर टेस्ट बट अ बेटर आफ्टर टेस्ट. सो मैं तो इंटेंशन भी जाता हूँ कि इस आदमी की नीयत अच्छी थी तभी इसने ये अच्छा फीडबैक दिया. लेट मी वर्क ऑन इट. आई ऑलवेज टेक एडवाइस एज समथिंग वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. आई थिंक इफ दिस पर्सन हैज टेकन दिस टाइम टू गिव मी एडवाइस आई शुड नॉट डिसअपॉइंट हिम और हर.
Absolutely. Pearls of wisdom coming out over there. Thank you so much, Deepak sir. You know, and being from a family of teachers, I have like teachers on both my sides of the family. And I have actually seen some of these things that you've just spoken about, how relevant students are to actually help teachers in their journeys. So I'll move to the next question, sir. And again, taking a cue from my own, personal example, I've been a campus recruiter, and each time, I meet the faculty, and we have some who've joined us today, we've always felt a very strong need to closely link the education space, with what is being practiced by industry. So what do you think is the importance of the industry-institute partnership for grooming our students such that, they can actually take on the real-world challenges?
Yeah, as I said, that teaching to me is a combination of rigor and relevance. Rigor is expertise and relevance is experience. Ye dono cheez zaruri hai. Now, when I first started teaching, I had no experience. Now, that doesn't mean you cannot be a teacher, but you learn every day as you move ahead. I said that now in business schools, you have this experiential learning. कुछ लोग कहते हैं रियल सिचुएशन लर्निंग वेर वी वॉन्ट स्टूडेंट्स टू गेट इन्वॉल्व इन रियल प्रोजेक्ट्स बिकॉज देयर दैट दे कैन अप्लाई द कॉन्सेप्ट्स दैट वी टीच. नाउ आई ऑल्सो टेल स्टूडेंट डोंट थिंक दैट एवरीथिंग दैट आई अप्लाई ऑन टीच यू फ्राइडे ऑन मंडे यू कैन इम्प्लीमेंट दैट बिकॉज समटाइम्स इट टेक्स लैग फॉर यू टू बिकम एक्सपर्ट एट इट टू अंडरस्टैंड इट प्रॉपरली. ये नहीं है कि एवरीथिंग इज जस्ट लाइक एंड आई गिव एन एग्जाम्पल. That it was in 1905, Einstein got the Nobel Prize on a paper he wrote called the photoelectric effect. Today, we see garage door openers. That garage door opener is nothing but the application of photoelectric effect. Einstein didn't think of garage door openers when he wrote the paper on photoelectric effect. Kaise demagnetize karte hain? My point is you need to have appreciation for good theory. Because these people are thinking 50 years from now, 100 years, unki jo thinking hai. But then there are other people who bring the practice together. That's why in business schools, we have both kind of professors of management practice, professors who are very good academics, and education to me is an amalgamation of the two. Class teaching, a teacher in a classroom is like the symphony conductor. Our role is to make sure that all the nodes are connected, then it becomes music. If one node is out of sync, it becomes noise. That's the role of a teacher. Ki usko kaise sara connect karke kiya jaye, just so that at the end, people feel the true words, the class was music to my ears. Aur wo tabhi aayega when you bring the right examples, and examples need not be examples, it can be stories. And one advice to students who are in the room I would give you, being an Indian is our biggest strength. If you ask me one thing that has given me all these jobs from INSEAD and others and here, once I had a lunch with the chairman of Motorola in the 90s, and I asked him, I said, Mr. Galvin, when you interview students, what do you look for? He said that if I get stuck at the airport, can I have a meaningful conversation with this person beyond Motorola? So I tell Indian students, share the cultural traits of the country. Rakhi kya hai? Holi ka tehwar kya hai? Ye cheez for those CEOs, they are not going to read a book. But when they read about these cultural traits, the women like a cultural adaptability, they learn something that what how human beings behave in different countries. So in my class, I don't need to bring a business relevance thing. I can bring a social significance thing. So what I did as a student, what people like to see is there a connection to what we are teaching and making a difference in the world? Whether a difference in business. So profits can be one thing, purpose can be another. Lekin, you have to personalize the class. That's like, human beings think. share personal stories, then people get interested in it.
Absolutely. And I think
मेरी तो सारी क्लास मेरी वाइफ सुनती है कि वही क्लास सुनती है, बट वो स्टोरीज हमेशा मुझे नहीं ऐसा लगता है मैं पहली बार सुन रहा हूँ. द वे यू सेड, क्योंकि मैं तैयार करके जाता नहीं, डोंट रीड ए स्क्रिप्ट, जो उसमें दिमाग में आता है वही बोलता हूँ. सो ऑल माई थिंग्स आर एक्सटेम्पोर, दिमाग में आ गया. अभी मैं सोचा भी नहीं था फरादी का एग्जाम्पल आ जाएगा, जब कनेक्टिंग डॉट्स है वो कहानी आ जाती है. सो यू हैव टू हैव योर एंटेना एंड इट वुड कम. वो जैसे टीवी में होता था ना, ऊपर जाके एंटेना एडजस्ट करेंगे तो पिक्चर अच्छी आएगी, ऐसे ही होता है कि वो एंटेना में थॉट्स आएगी. आपका काम है कि वो पिक्चर को एक अच्छा बना दो.
सब बिल्कुल वैसा ही चल रहा है अभी भी. आई थिंक आपकी स्टोरीज दे आर सो सो इंटरेस्टिंग कि ऐसे मन ही नहीं कर रहा कि हम खत्म करें. आई विल मूव टू अनदर क्वेश्चन सर. इनफैक्ट काफी सारे क्वेश्चन आ रहे हैं. सो you know, this one actually is, again, I think quite relevant today, and I'll probably set a little bit of a context. So my mother's a primary school teacher and in an army school. And I think this recent pandemic, we've heard so much about, you know, such heartwarming stories to see how schools and faculties have actually transitioned to this new normal. But often we discuss if this element of, say, walking up to a teacher to solve a query or having those, you know, lovely interactive charts that the students could go through all the time. So in times of online teaching, how valuable is the classroom and the social learning experience?
The answer is not either or. What I think the COVID has taught us, and my colleagues are there, Mr. Krishnan and others can add. Some of the professors of Kellogg School, they come home and they tell me that this was the first time they taught online because there was nothing. But what they found was their ratings were better as an online teacher than as a classroom teacher. And the reason is when you teach online, you are more efficient. You focus on the content. Class mein kya hota hai, some students would just ask an irrelevant question. A lot of distractions happen. So again, as I said, as a music conductor, you do this thing well. But life actually, to me, what the biggest thing I learned from coronavirus, and when I still my classes, this concept of hybrid or blended learning. Lots of people ask me this question, that Professor Jain, as a business school dean, what do you teach in business schools? And this question comes from people from physics, engineering. They say in physics, we have a set of principles, we teach Newton's laws and Einstein theory and others. In business schools, what do you teach? I give a very simple example. As in business schools, what we teach our student is how you put structure on unstructured problems. Business education is structured thinking, sound reasoning, and fast acting. देखिए ये business education है. So we thread. So my point is courses that are well structured should not be taught in the classroom. Derivative of x square is 2x. उसमें मुझे students की opinion नहीं चाहिए. Financial accounting is a set of accounting. These courses, microeconomics, in future education, I would put these courses online. Let students prepare them, have a proficiency exam, whether they cross the threshold or not. And classroom teaching should be more on courses like critical thinking, where you want to draw upon their talent and treat students as co-creators of knowledge. The word students in future, the customer word in future would become partners. ये ट्रांजेक्शनल नहीं होगा, ये सब रिलेशनशिप होगा. उनका पर्पस है लर्निंग और आपका पर्पस है एनहेंस्ड लर्निंग. एंड द अदर थिंग आई टेल स्टूडेंट इज सेपरेट लर्निंग फ्रॉम अर्निंग. डोंट थिंक बिजनेस स्कूल में आके यू आर ऑप्टिमाइजिंग. लर्निंग अगर अच्छा होगा तो अर्निंग अपने आप आएगा, बट ये लर्निंग बाद में नहीं मिलेगी. अर्निंग तो सारी उम्र करना है. गो इफ यू हैव स्पेयर टाइम, गो एंड मीट द प्रोफेसर इंडिविजुअली, गेट टू नो व्हाट देयर रिसर्च दे आर डूइंग. Sometimes some students have become part of my research board. They went and collected data. Unko maine sikhaya ki kaise hum log model fit karte hain, kya hai. So, and those students then go and become good PhD students and have become faculty. I just want to share a small story. Yesterday, my daughter called me and she's doing her MBA at UCLA. So she's taking a course on brand management. The professor's name is Sanjay Sood. So he came to the class, he got introduction and he said, Dhwani Jain. So he said, I don't want to embarrass Dhwani, but his dad made me a professor. He was in my class. He taught my market research class, an MBA student at Kellogg, and my new products management. He found it so interesting that he decided to go for PhD. I wrote a recommendation. He did his PhD from Stanford, and now today he's a professor. He says, I am here because of his dad. So our job is that otherwise, how we would move this cycle, this you need to keep the wheel rotating and create more wheels and bigger wheels And that is the purpose of teaching, is to create an interest in the topic.
Sir, and I think you've created that interest so much. I'd just like to read out a comment that we've received. It's a comment from Prince Bindal. He's a former student of yours, sir, at Kellogg, and he just wanted to convey his regards to you. And listening to you has always been a pleasure for him, and he has actually put that comment out. So I think, you know, what you're saying is actually visible to all of us as we speak. So this is so heartening. Thanks so much, Prince Bindal, for sharing this. Sir, we have a question from, you know, Professor D.P. Goyal from IIM Shillong. And his question is that you've talked about the significance, you know, so what is your take on research papers being published in top rated journals by the faculty these days? And given that it has a lot of weightage and ranking, so what's your thought on research papers?
What is, just like students learn, hamari learning kahan se hoti hai, when we create new bodies of knowledge, when you look at any mission of a institution in academics, first is knowledge creation, then knowledge dissemination, and third is knowledge certification. Knowledge creation is research, knowledge dissemination, we disseminate knowledge with teaching, and knowledge certification is IIM can give a degree to the student, who certify karte. I am a big believer that initial years of professors should be focused on research because they have so many good ideas. And they should work hard to get this. What is publication? Publication means it is a certification that this work is so good, it was published in this leading journal. Mm-hmm. Or isme, there is no shortcut. I wrote my first paper in 1985. Until 1989 May, I was had zero publication. Ek paper except nahi was sab reject hue. In 1989, I was up for my first review. Or March tak कोई पेपर पब्लिश नहीं हुआ था. सो मुझे बहुत लोग कहने आए कि दीपक यू शुड स्टार्ट लुकिंग फॉर अनदर जॉब बिकॉज यू डोंट नो डीन जेकब्स, ही हैज अ हिट लिस्ट. तुम तो शिट लिस्ट में आ गए हो, कुछ पब्लिश नहीं है. मैंने बोला देखो होगा. आई नेवर गेव अप होप. एंड यू वोंट बिलीव, इन 1989 छह महीने में आई गॉट 7 पेपर्स एक्सेप्टेड जो सारे रिजेक्ट हो रहे थे. एंड आई वॉज प्रोमोटेड, एंड इन 5 ईयर्स आई वॉज प्रोमोटेड टू अ फुल प्रोफेसर. Never give up. But you have to try for the top journals. ये नहीं है कि हम इंडिया में बैठ के नहीं कर सकते हैं. दिक्कत यह है कि we are used to getting quick wins. Life में कोई shortcut नहीं है. People who take shortcuts also cut short their lives. ये छोटे, देखिए एक बच्चा होने में 9 महीने लगते हैं. Pre-born babies को ठीक होने में time लगता है. हर चीज का एक वक्त होता है. यू हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट द प्रोसेस, यू हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट टॉप जर्नल्स. और उसमें हो सकता है, और उसके लिए माय एडवाइस टू मिस्टर कपूर इज समटाइम्स सम प्रोफेसर नीड टू गो एंड बी इन दैट एनवायरमेंट. तो कई बार मैं क्या करता हूँ, जो ISB पे भी था, वी सेंड पीपल टू गो एंड टेक अ सेबेटिकल एंड स्पेंड 6 मंथ्स इन सम गुड इंस्टीट्यूशन इन अमेरिका वेयर दे कैन लर्न सिट इन PhD कोर्सेस, लर्न कि एक पेपर में कैसे करते हैं, क्या ट्रेनिंग चाहिए. We as dean should also create that environment for people who are seeking to do that, to give them the best possible option to do that. But uske bina aapko certification nahi milta hai ki you are a good teacher. A good teacher is then you can get good teaching ratings, but then your knowledge over time can only deplete. Research say you get new ideas. Not that I am a big believer in professor management practice. Jo aate hain CEOs vagera, unka ek dusra domain hai. और जो रिसर्च प्रोफेसर है उनका दूसरा डोमेन है. वी बोथ कैन लर्न फ्रॉम ईच अदर, बट आई एम ए बिग बिलीवर दैट रिसर्च माइंडसेट से आप कभी बुढ़ापा नहीं आएगा, बिकॉज यू आर ऑलवेज थिंकिंग ऑफ न्यू थिंग, यू विल नेवर एज.
Wonderful. Thank you so much, Deepak sir. We have a very nice question from one of our students who's posted on social media, Yash Vyas. He's asking, during our early management career, what does a student need to focus on? Jack of all or master of one?
I am a very big believer. Do few things, but do it very well. जब मैं कोर्स पढ़ाता हूँ, अगर मेरा कोर्स पे में 18 चैप्टर किताब में, आई मे ओनली एंड अप टीचिंग 5 चैप्टर्स, बट वट एवर आई टीच फोकस ऑन डेप्थ नॉट ऑन द ब्रेथ. तो माय थिंग इज बी गुड एट समथिंग, वही आपका ब्रांड है. एंड ओवर टाइम यू विल हैव टाइम टू लर्न अदर थिंग्स, बट एक चीज में तो मास्टर लो. Because somebody asked this question and I would tell you, मुझे sixth grade में I stood first in the class. तो एक मुझे gift मिला, वो prize मिला, वो किताब थी पंडित राधा कृष्ण की. तो उस किताब में बहुत अच्छे question, somebody asked President Radha Krishnan this question, that President Radha Krishnan, what do you think of luck in life? कि आप luck से president बन गए ये है. He gave a very beautiful answer कि luck और efforts में क्या. He said, when you play cards, the deck of cards you get is your luck. What you make of those cards is your efforts. अगर ताश खेलना सीखो तो अच्छे जुआरी बनो. वो भी एक कला है. Now, I always say, whatever you learn, be a master in that. That is what I have done. I cannot be everything to everyone. आज तक मुझे ना गाड़ी चलानी आती है ना कंप्यूटर आता है. मैं तो अभी भी ब्लैकबोर्ड और कोई मुझे लिखता है तो हाथ से लिख के नोट भेज देता हूँ. That is not a point of differentiation. मेरी अंग्रेजी वैसी ही है जैसे एक इंडियन की होती है. अब 40 साल हो गए अमेरिका में रहते. आई एम हु आई एम, बट वॉट आई लाइक टू फोकस ऑन, आई डू इट विद ड्यू डिलीजेंस एंड फुल सिंसियरिटी. उसमें कभी नोबडी वुड डाउट माय प्रोफेशनल इंटीग्रिटी कि दीपक ने ये काम ऐसे टाल दिया. वो आपका ब्रांड बनता है. सो आई एम नॉट ए बिग बिलीवर कि सब हो. एंड द सेकेंड एडवाइस इज learn as much as possible. Focus on learning, and if you can only learn two things, I have a very simple answer to this person. Follow one rule that I tell my students in the last class, a rule of 2-2-2. Pick any two industries that you like. Duniya mein itne sare aap sabke bare mein nahi janenge. Pick any two you like. For me, the two are airlines and pharmaceuticals. इनमें मुझे इंटरेस्ट है. इन ईच इंडस्ट्री देर आर सो मेनी प्लेयर्स. पिक एनी टू प्लेयर्स इन ईच इंडस्ट्री. तो अब आपके हाथ में क्या हो गए, चार. दो इंडस्ट्री के दो. सो आई फोकस ऑन नोवार्टिस एंड ईलाई लिली एक कंपनी है, एंड यूनाइटेड एयरलाइंस एंड थाई इंटरनेशनल, जिनके साथ मैंने काम किया. एंड देन पिक टू पब्लिकेशंस, एक डेली न्यूज़पेपर और एक कोई वीकली बिजनेस मैगजीन. एंड इन दिस न्यूज़पेपर एंड मैगजीन रीड अबाउट दोज कंपनीज ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. विद इन सिक्स मंथ्स टू ईयर यू वुड बिकम एन एक्सपर्ट इन दैट इंडस्ट्री एंड यू वुड बी एबल टू राइट अ बुक ऑन दैट. हर आदमी सबके बारे में पढ़ता है. जब आप दो कंपनी के बारे में पढ़ोगे, यू वुड रीड अबाउट देयर कंपेटिटर्स ऑल्सो. आपको पता चल जाएगा कि इस इंडस्ट्री की डायनामिक्स क्या है. So focus on this two industries, two players in each industry, two newspaper, और उनमें उन industries के बारे में जरूर पढ़ो. आपके पास उसका notes, मैं तो paper काट काट के रखते रहता हूँ दो folder में, और over time you can write a book on the. मैंने किताब लिखी थी Unsustained Unprofitability. I never think airlines would make money. Sustained Unprofitability. क्योंकि कुछ ना कुछ आ जाता. कोरोना वायरस आ गया, ऐसे भट्टा बैठ गया. 9/11 आया, उस समय हो गया. कुछ ना कुछ ऐसी इवेंट्स आ जाती है कि एयरलाइंस के लिए पैसा बनाना इतना आसान नहीं है. तभी ये जो लो कॉस्ट एयरलाइंस का क्या मॉडल है. सो पिक एनी थिंग दैट यू आर पैशनेट अबाउट एंड रीड अबाउट दैट ऑन ए रेगुलर बेसिस, लॉन्जिट्यूडनल डेटा. तभी आप मास्टर बनोगे. सब दुनिया में जर्नी करें. और ये दो कहानियाँ किसी को सुनाओगे तो सब, ये दोनों ऐसी इंडस्ट्री है जो हर ह्यूमन बींग को टच करती है. ट्रैवल भी सबको मजा आता है, बीमार भी सब पड़ते हैं. बीमार नहीं है हम बैठ के, हेल्दी लाइफ क्वालिटी. सो मैं हमेशा कहता हूँ, एक हेल्थ केयर और एक वेल्थ केयर होता है, और एक होता है सारा आपका टू हॉस्पिटैलिटी. सो हेल्थ केयर एंड हॉस्पिटैलिटी इंडस्ट्री में आई लाइक टू फोकस माय अटेंशन.
Very nice. Thank you so much, Deepak sir. I think, Yash, I hope you heard the mantras that sir has shared, and they really, really help you. In fact, they're going to help all of us. This is truly a masterclass. In the interest of time, sir, I'll take one more question which we have from, in fact, there are so many, it's difficult to choose, but, you know, I'm sure this will be something which even others will want to know. There's a question from R. Vishak, and he's asking, what is that one book you wish every student or youngster would read at least once?
See, I want to tell you something. I don't read anything. क्योंकि read करने के बाद वो secondary knowledge हो जाती है. तो लोग कहते हैं मुझे वो good to great पढ़ो, और ये art of saying no, इतनी इतनी किताबें रोज आती हैं. मैं तो बिल्कुल कुछ नहीं पढ़ता. I read newspaper क्योंकि to know the events, business publication से वो कहानियाँ पता चलती है. लेकिन ये किताब मैं नहीं पढ़ता हूँ. सो आई मे नॉट बी द राइट पर्सन, देर आर सो मेनी बुक्स टू रीड, बट वन थिंग आई डू ऑन ए डेली बेसिस इज 1962 में मेरे फादर जब स्कूल लेके गए थे, मेरे बाबूजी हमको स्कूल क्यों जाना है, तो बोले यू गो टू स्कूल टू लर्न द 3 आर्स, रीडिंग राइटिंग एंड अरिथमेटिक. ये एक इंग्लिश फ्रेज था. टुडे आई टेल दिस पर्सन दैट टुडे वी आई बिलीव इन 3 आर्स. पहला है रिफ्लेक्शन, यू नीड टू रिफ्लेक्ट ऑन वट यू हैव अचीव्ड एंड योर एक्सपीरियंस. सेकेंड इज रिन्यूअल, यू नीड टू रिन्यू योर थॉट्स, यू नीड टू इवॉल्व. वो पुरानी चीज को लेके अगर बैठे रहोगे तो कभी उद्धार नहीं होगा. You need to evolve, जिसको मैं कहता हूँ renewal. You need to renew your experience. And third is responsibility. And that is to me the journey of success to significance. So most of my time today, I don't have a full-time job. I spend time creating, मैंने एक बांग्लादेश में यूनिवर्सिटी बनाई है, AUW, Asian University for Women. And this is for Muslim women, because मेरा ये है कि if you educate women, they will then focus that on their children. तो इन 2009 में जब पहला बैच आया था तो अफगान गर्ल केम टू मी एंड सेड, प्रोफेसर जैन, दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई एम, वी टारगेट 6 कंट्रीज, अफगानिस्तान, पाकिस्तान, नेपाल, श्रीलंका, कंबोडिया एंड वियतनाम, मुस्लिम गर्ल्स फ्रॉम दिस. तो बोलता है दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम आई गेट टू सी द सन, बिकॉज अफगानिस्तान में भी हम लोग हमेशा वो पर्दे में रहते हैं और ठंड पड़ती है. दैट गर्ल डिड सो वेल इन द फर्स्ट ईयर, वी सेंट हर एन एक्सचेंज स्टूडेंट टू स्टैनफर्ड थ्रू अवर लिंक. She graduated with a degree from this Bangladesh University and a certificate from Stanford. Aaj us class mein 17 ladkiyan hain Afghanistan se. That was the first batch. One, today we have 17 girls from Afghanistan. I said that ye jo Syrian refugees hain, jo bhagte hain, inko padhao. Mufat khana dene se kuch nahi hoga. Create a school for them. So I spend a lot of time in Central America aajkal. Honduras, Nicaragua, Salvador. यहाँ पर उनके जो प्रेसिडेंट हैं वो मुझे जानते हैं. आप बिलीव कर, जो मेरी ब्रेन सर्जरी हुई थी, द प्रेसिडेंट ऑफ ग्वाटेमाला एंड हिज वाइफ केम टू सी मी इन द हॉस्पिटल. और दूसरा जो एक आया था, दिस वुड बी माय लास्ट थिंग, मेरे फादर एक बात कहते थे हमेशा कि बेटा इंसान जीतता है अपनी औलाद से और हारता भी अपनी औलाद के आगे. तो इसलिए मेरे फादर की तबीयत काफ़ी ख़राब थी. अक्टूबर 2008 में मैं उनसे हर महीने मिलने आता था. He was in ICU. मेरा फोन बजा. I came out, took the phone. मैं वापस अंदर गया तो मेरे से पूछते बेटा किसका फोन था. मैंने बोला अंबानी साहब का फोन था, आपकी तबीयत के बारे में पूछ रहे थे. तो मेरे फादर बोले कहा मुकेश अंबानी जैसा आदमी, मेरे जैसा आदमी, एक तेजपुर का आदमी, मैं माय फादर वॉज अ क्लर्क. तो मेरे सिर पे हाथ रख के बोले बेटा तुमने आज मुझे जिता दिया. मैं कभी सोचा नहीं था कि है. After that, I went back to Chicago that evening. I reached the airport and he passed away. वो दिन उनके लिए एक निर्वाण का दिन था. तो when you see people like this, whether it is the बड़े लोग हैं, everyone is a human being. मैं बोलता नहीं हूँ, एक मेरा बहुत favorite student है who heard about me and used to come and take marketing lessons from me, and that is President Obama. When he wanted to get to Obama, somebody introduced him to me. मैं कैलॉग का डीन था. Dean, I have heard a lot about you. I want to become a marketing. How should I market myself? I want to be a senator. So I used to meet him on Saturday, 1 hour, give him, and I asked to ask him to give 1 hour to my MBA students, who were black MBA students, to show them that there is also a light for them. He was very religious. 10 to 11 Saturday morning time with Deepak Jain, 11 to 11:45 with Black Management Association. हमने 2003 में किया, 4 में किया, 5 में किया, 8 के बाद तो प्रेसिडेंट ही बन गए. फिर तो आई हैव सीन ऑल दिस पीपल. मैं एक एक हर इंसान अनाज खाता है, 2 रोटी खाता है, चाहे बड़ा हो छोटा हो. इंसानियत, ह्यूमिलिटी को मत भूलो. एंड पीपल वुड सी थ्रू थिंग्स. सो बड़े बड़े लोगों से भी किया है. व्हेन आई गो टू केलॉग स्कूल, द फर्स्ट थिंग आई डू इज हग द जेनिटर जो बाथरूम साफ कर रहा है, और ऊपर जाके जो मेरे डीन है उनको भी हग. मेरे तो ये नेचर है. कभी आदमी में कभी डिफ्रेंशिएशन नहीं लाता हूँ. प्रेसिडेंट ओबामा भी एक इंसान है और जेनिटर, दोनों के रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज है, दोनों डिफरेंट काम करते हैं, बट उनके कॉन्सिक्वेंस. जेनिटर का काम है कमरा साफ करना, इसके ऊपर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी इतनी है कि वर्ल्ड को पीस, प्रॉस्पेरिटी और हारमोनी कैसे लानी है. सो द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज आर डिफरेंट, बट बोथ हैव इम्पोर्टेंट रोल.
Very, very nice. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing such lovely stories. I mean, you know, we are all very, very proud that we of you and that we got this opportunity to actually hear such lovely stories from you. Sir, and I genuinely think that there is so much that you've shared. However, we'd still like to know some things that, you know, you find you prefer as choices. So are you ready to play a very quick game with me? It'll take 2 minutes.
Yes, I am at your disposal.
Great. So we are going to play a very simple game, sir, and it's called This or That. So it's basically like choices. So I'll give you two choices and you have to just tell me which one do you prefer. So let's play an example. So like tea or coffee?
Tea.
Yeah. So like that, I'm going to give you some more choices and you have to tell me which one do you prefer. Yeah. Okay, great. So first one, read minds or see the future?
You cannot say both.
No, sir. You have to choose one. Sometimes you can say both, but read minds. Okay. Next. All right, sir. Next one. Night owl or a morning person?
Morning.
Morning. The smell of old books or the shine of a new gadget?
Old books.
Cricket or football?
Football.
Awesome. So malls or monuments?
Monuments.
Monuments. Visit the future or reminisce the past?
Yeah, to both.
Both. Okay. One is allowed, sir. One, you can do both. All right. So next one, work hard or play hard?
Work hard.
Quality or quantity?
Quality.
Okay. Explore the world or relax at home?
Explore the world.
And the last one, and you can't say both for this one, sir, statistics or marketing?
Statistics.
Very nice. Thank you so much, sir. This was so much fun. You know, it's amazing how honestly and very quickly you answered this. This was, you were such a wonderful sport. Thank you so much, sir, for playing this with me. Now, sir, yes, sir.
I sincerely apologize for being too personal and sharing personal stories. Kuch logon ka nahi hai. I just couldn't.
No, sir, they were. Absolutely. They are such, you know, stories which are so inspiring, and it will actually make all of us believe that we can all do wonderful things. And I'm sure all the students and our faculty who's joined us from so many institutes will take so much from it. And sir, you know, on that note, you'll be very happy to know that this platform, The Ultimate Pitch, over the last 5 years, it's, you know, grown to attract many entrepreneurial minds. And that's something which, you know, even you shared in terms of how our entire teaching philosophy also should be shifting. And you know, we started fairly small with just about 16 students and 500 students in the first season. So today we are reaching out to innumerable institutes and we've got more than 10,000 students who are ideating. Now, the passion and the drive of the students is very, very commendable. And we'd also like to applaud the ecosystem in which, you know, they are being propelled. So right now, what we're going to do is we really salute the institutes and the educators of our country that strive, even in, you know, challenging times like the ones that we are seeing right now, to ensure that our young minds learn and flourish and take the responsibility on driving this nation forward. So today we are going to recognize some of the institutes who have stood firm on their journey and to propel this entrepreneurial thinking that we've been speaking about. So it's a perfect way. Great, sir. So it's a perfect way actually to, you know, bring this whole TUP We Evolve Masterclass series to a close. And we have our very own TUP awards that we are going to be doing for the very first time. So audience, you know, if you want to guess on who is probably winning the title, please feel free to put it down in the comment box. But I think, sir, let's get straight into it. So without further ado, let's get into the categories. Our first award is TUP Idea Generator Award. Now, this award is to recognize an institute with the most number of ideas that have been submitted this year in TUP in proportion to the batch size. And any guesses to which institute this award goes to? Let's see if we have any comments that are coming in into the chat box. Well, so this award goes to IIM Shillong. Congratulations. I would like to call upon the director of IIM Shillong, Professor DP Goyal. Many, many congratulations. You know, it's so nice to have you with us.
Thank you so much. Thank
Goyal, sir. Bahut bahut mubarakbad.
Thank you so much, Deep sir. Thank you so much.
Professor Goyal, over to you. Some words that you'd like to share.
I would like to thank Reliance for the Ultimate Pitch. And we at IIM Shillong are delighted to receive this award. Thank you very much, and special thanks for connecting us to Dr. Deep Jain. Thank you so much.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Professor Deep Goyal, and really, really looking forward to some amazing ideas through the next seasons from IIM Shillong, and all the very best.
Yeah, in fact.
I think we lost Professor Goyal. Nevertheless, Professor Goyal's back.
No,
yes,
I just wanted to say that it is a great honor for our students.
Thank you, sir. In fact, we've had some great ideas coming from IIM Shillong over the last few seasons. So good luck to them as well. Okay, so we'll move to the next category. And the next category is TUP Early Bird Campus Award. Now, naturally, as the title suggests, this award is for the campus which has these really enthusiastic students who have multiple ideas that are brewing, and very quickly they are brewing. And thus, they were amongst the first few who sent in their submissions to us. So this award goes to IMI New Delhi. Congratulations, Director General Dr. Himadri Das, who's with us from IMI Delhi. Thank you so much for joining us, sir.
Himadri,
thank you very much.
Good to see you again.
Again, good to see you. Wonderful.
Yes.
It's always a pleasure.
Professor Das, over to you, if you'd like to say a few words.
Yeah, surely. First of all, a huge thanks to Reliance for doing this competition for the last 5 years. And it's a real privilege that IMI New Delhi has won this award. Credit must go to two sets of people in IMI New Delhi. First of all, to the students for being so enthusiastic and for sending in so many ideas, and that too early, and not waiting till the last minute, which is the problem with a lot of us. We wait till the end. But our students were very early, and I must give them credit for that. And I must equally give credit to all our faculty for mentoring them, for supporting them, and for creating that ecosystem where the students felt enthused to go ahead and, you know, give their ideas. At a personal level, I am particularly delighted that I am receiving, on behalf of IIM New Delhi, this award from Dr. Deepak Jain. Dr. Jain and I have been interacting for quite some time now, and I value his inputs. I have picked his brains on multiple occasions, and he has actually, on my sending an email, he has called me from the US to give me advice that I was seeking. So I thought he'll just write me a few lines, but he actually picked up the phone and called me. And this is something that makes Dr. Jain a very, very unique person. And for a business school professor, I think he's a role model for all our business school professors and academic leaders. So it's a personal honor that I'm here to receive it from Dr. Deepak Jain. Thank you very much to Reliance and Dr. Jain.
Keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Dr. Das, and congratulations to the students, faculty, and to you for winning this. And we look forward to IMI New Delhi always being the early bird, students and teams. So thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right, let's move to the third award category, and which is the Ultimate Pitch Innovate with Curiosity Award. Now, this goes to the curious students who have been the most engaged as a campus throughout the TUP journey. And this obviously means that there was great participation, comments in all our launches, as well as the campus rounds. And this award goes to SIBM Pune. I would like to call upon Director of SIBM, Dr. Raman. Dr. Raman, so nice to see you after so long, and good to meet you virtually. Over to you to say a few words.
Congratulations, Dr. Raman.
Thank you, Aarti, and thank you, Professor Deepak Jain. It was a pleasure listening to you. And I must thank Reliance for two things. One, for the award, for sure, and second, for creating this platform where we could listen to Professor Deepak Jain. So these are the two big thank you to Reliance. And we've been doing great at TUP year after year, and this came as a pleasant surprise that you initiated these awards. And SIBM Pune students must be thanked, along with the alumni and the faculty members. Both of them who give a lot of input, and this is a student-run institution, let me tell you that. Here we have student councils, and that's how the engagement built up. It built up to that extent that today we are here for this award. So my thanks to my students who made it happen, and thank you once again, Reliance, for giving this opportunity to listen to Professor Deepak Jain. In fact, I was taking notes, the camera was off, but I think pearls of wisdom, sir. It was absolute pleasure listening to you. Thank you so much.
Great. Thank you so much, Dr. Raman, and many congratulations to all the teams from SIBM. And yes, we've had some fantastic alumni who continue to support this particular platform. And for everyone else who perhaps didn't take notes, don't worry, this session is soon going to be on YouTube. So you can certainly listen to Deepak sir over and over again. Thanks so much, Dr. Raman, for joining us.
Thank you. Thank you.
And with this, we move to our final award this evening, and that is to recognize the institute which consistently propels the entrepreneurial thinking year on year in their students, and that is the Ultimate Pitch Longstanding Entrepreneurs Award. Now, this goes to the institute that has consistently been coming in the winning categories over the last 5 seasons. So any guesses from our audience on this one? Well, I guess I can see some correct guesses coming in, and it is IIM Bangalore. So IIM Bangalore has won the ultimate champion, that is the first place for the last 2 seasons of TUP in a row, that is season 4.0 and 5.0. And we have director of IIM Bangalore, Professor Rishikesh Krishnan, who is with us. Congratulations, sir, and I'm sure this is a proud moment for you and the faculty and the students of IIM Bangalore. So request you to please say a few words.
Thank you very much, Aarti. Thank you for including us in this ceremony. IIMB has been doing quite a lot to focus on entrepreneurship and innovation. It's a part of our mission statement. We have a very strong entrepreneurship and incubation program. And we're one of the few schools who also has entrepreneurship in its core curriculum. So I'm not surprised, but also delighted that our students have been doing so well. It was wonderful to hear Deepak today, always great to be reminded of many of the important things in life, and Deepak's a great source of inspiration. So thanks to Reliance and to all of you for having or giving us this opportunity to listen to Deepak again, and of course for giving us these awards. Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Professor Krishnan, such a pleasure to have you. And it's great that a platform like this actually, you know, helps all the faculty meet as well. So thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you.
So on that note, sir, the reason we wanted to do these awards this year is it's been 5 years, and we've certainly seen so many of these students striving so hard, thinking big, and hence we thought, as a token of appreciation, to kind of give back. And that's the reason why we've started with these TUP awards, and we hope to continue, year on year to ensure that this entrepreneurial thinking that we've tried to propel through TUP space. So on that note, sir, I, of course, would like to hand this back to you to share any parting message or advice that you have. I mean, as an educator, I'm sure you're beaming with pride seeing so many of these institutes and students doing well. So if any parting message or advice you have for our students and participants, that will be great.
Now, my only word to all the students is there is no substitute to hard work. With hard work, you can achieve anything. Hard work with a very clear intentions. People may differ on in their level of smartness and IQ, but if you work hard and believe in the people you work with, mera success sara logon se aaya hai. Whether they are students, they are my colleagues. When I was a student, my father had no resources. So teacher knew about this thing. So shaam ko 3 baje wo mujhe kitab de dete the, Deepak ki kitab bhej raha, raat ko padh lena, kal aake mujhe dena. Mere paas kitab khareedne ke paise nahi the. Wo padh liya, agle din main class mein tha, to ek course tha reading ka, where the teacher would ask the people to read. And then suddenly she will stop and ask the second student to read from that line, knowing whether you have paid attention.
Correct.
So the teacher saw that I was sitting there without a book in hand. So bola, aaj to isko zarur punishment dena hai. So she stopped the other person and said, Deepak, now your turn. So mera jo 7th ka student tha, maine uski kitab li and I read from this next line. She was very surprised. She didn't say anything. Class khatam hone ke baad mujhe office mein bulaya. I saw you with no books in the hand, and when I asked you, you read it perfectly, the right place to start with. So, raat ko maine padhi thi, so I knew what the whole book was. And so then she gave me a specimen copy. Unke paas extra thi ki ye tum ek rakho. So people would help you if they see the best in you. I can tell you hundreds of things. All thing what Himadri said and everything. If people ask you to do something, try not to say no. Agar bas ki baat hai aur nahi hai to usi samay no karo. Don't. बहुत लोगों का तो ऐसा होता है हाँ देखा जाएगा बिकॉज दैट पर्सन होप कीप्स इंक्रीजिंग द मोर यू डिले एंड देन दे कम एंड यू आर नॉट एबल टू डू बी वेरी फर्म बट फेयर एंड इफ आई हैव टू गो बैक एंड लुक एट माई लाइफ इट्स ऑल हार्ड वर्क विद फुल सिंसेरिटी एंड डोंट ट्राई टू डू एवरीथिंग जो मैंने कहा जिस एक टॉपिक को लो लर्न इट वेल And over time, you will have enough time to move beyond that. And people would, if you know something, people can easily get this impression, okay, this person was sincerity, yeah, as I said, earn the trust of the people you work for and work with. And trust is independent of cultures. A China mein bhi mujhe jo rakha hai, you know the relations between India and China. But for them to hire an Indian to head of a very top school, our executive MBA, this time we were rated number 2. In MBA programs, we are rated a worldwide between 5-7, which is the number 1 school is what? INSEAD. Number 2, Kellogg aata hai, number 3, agar SIBS aata hai, main teenon jagah ka dean raha. So my point is, France mein jaake, hum log jab chote the, I only want to give, 1960s mein ek movie thi, An Evening in Paris, badi famous movie thi. कभी उस समय 1969 में नहीं सोचा था कि ये डे वुड कम व्हेन फॉर मी एवरी इवनिंग वुड बी इन पेरिस जब मैं पेरिस रहता था इनसीआर का डीन एंड इवनिंग इन पेरिस बिकेम एवरी इवनिंग इन पेरिस तो ये वो आईफल टावर घर के खिड़की खोलते थे दिखता था सो एवरीथिंग इज अचीवेबल वर्क विद सिंसियरिटी नो सब्स्टिट्यूट ऑफ हार्ड वर्क एंड देयर इज नो गिफ्ट इन लाइफ यू हैव टू अर्न इट Or if you work hard, people would see through it and give it to you. And as I said, no challenge ahead of you is greater than the force behind you. I want to conclude this. I am always behind you. If you can get my email address, it's very simple. Mera naam hai Deepak, but I spell D-I-P-A-K. Deepak C, middle initial, Jain at gmail.com. You will definitely get an answer.
Great. Thank you so much, sir. I'm sure bahut sare mails abhi aapko aane wale hain because we have such a interactive audience over here and of course they'll certainly be writing to you.
Mail lambi hogi, mera jawab ek ya do word hoga kyunki mujhe type karna nahi aata. To ye kisi ne bolna tha phone utha ke phone pe baat kar do.
Great, wonderful. Thank you so much, sir, for joining us. It's such, pata hi nahi chala how the time actually went and those lovely stories of yours.
Thank you to Mr. Krishnan. Congratulations to Mr. Raman, Goyal Saab, Himadri Saab. You all are creating what I call the leaders of the future. Or ye jo intellectual curiosity hai, entrepreneurial thinking hai, let's promote this. Because I really believe that this century would be the century for us, the Indians. Dekhiye, business schools mein to hum log ne naam kar hi liya, abhi Harvard ke dean bhi Indian ban gaye. If I would not have gone to China, my other option was to be the dean of Sloan, MIT. But I didn't want to take MIT job because it competes with Kellogg. So MIT, kaho, Kellogg, kaho, University of Chicago, kaho, Harvard, kaho, ye sare jo tops, hum sab wahan pahunch chuke hain. So now the ball is in the court of all the people listening. If you work hard, sare achhe achhe companyon ke CEOs, And I'd want also people to go into not-for-profit organizations, NGOs. Social significance is also a very, very good area. You can make a big difference in the lives of people. So don't think that business school means only business. Think beyond business.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. And wonderful having you. Thank you.
Reliance for doing these things. I also happens to be a director of Reliance. And personally, but I think we should continue this thing on behalf of Reliance to ignite the young minds and create a better future for people who are aspiring for it and Absolutely. Are willing to work towards it.
And we look forward to your support always, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. Really, really nice. Thank you so much for being with us. Thank you. Okay, so what a wonderful close to our TUP WeEvolve Masterclass series. And this was truly a masterclass. But of course, our TUP community lives on. And through each one of you ideating souls, who we are sure will keep the spirit of thinking big alive, especially with such lovely lessons coming your way through this series. Our semi-finalists are set to take on their next challenge, and that is to face our jury in the TUP semi-finals. But TUP community, this is certainly not the end for you. Your job starts now because you need to push your favorite idea further and make it reach the grand finale. Now, how will you do that? Well, our semi-finalist teams are going to be showcasing their ideas through a one-of-a-kind 3D virtual idea fair, which is on the 22nd of February from 4 p.m. to 6 p.m. So you can actually vote for your favorite ideas at the Idea Fair and help them win the Ultimate Pitch Popular Choice Award. For the team that will win, they will get a direct entry to the grand finale. So mark your calendars, and I'm going to repeat that. 22nd February, 4 p.m. So don't let your guard down. Stay safe. It's me, Aarti, signing off, and see you all very soon. Keep ideating.